Good day everyone, my name is Shola Jalo Ashegwe Brown. I will be taking us on linear programming, an aspect of optimization. So linear programming is a vital area in optimization techniques that can be used to minimize or maximize our resources. We all could bear witness that resources that are available to production manager are limited in nature. So by this, we need to maximize the output we are getting from our resources, or we minimize the resources we commit to production system. So today I'll be taking us on linear programming. Linear programming have two functions. It's either it minimize or it maximize. So what and what are we minimizing? What and what are we maximizing? Now anything that goes into production system must be minimized. Why anything that comes out of production system must be maximized? Do you get that? So, for instance, we all know that profit is an output of production system. So, it must be what? Maximized. So, we maximize profit, you maximize your sales. Now, time is minimized. Space is minimized. So, costs, they are minimized. So anything that goes into production system that will take something away from us must be minimized. But something that will add value to us must be maximized. Okay. So today I'm going to work on this then with an illustration. So now, for example, Shola the Nigeria PLC produces two types of bread, sliced bread and agege bread. The company makes use of flour and butter in its production. 10 kg of flour is required to produce a loaf of sliced bread, while 20 kg of butter is needed to make a loaf of agege bread. 8 kg of flour is needed for a loaf of sliced bread, while 8 kg of butter is also needed for a loaf of agege bread. Shola has 120 kg of flour and 80 kg of butter in store. He makes 12 naira profit on sliced bread and 16 naira profit on agege bread. Now asks us to find the optimal product mix. Now we can see right now that Shola Nigeria PLC is producing two bread, agege bread and sliced bread, and in their store they make use of flour and butter as raw materials they use. Now in store they have 120 kg of flour and 80 kg of butter. Now, how will Shola now maximize these resources that you will get best profit from it? So the first thing you are supposed to do is just that you are supposed to translate this word problem to linear programming model. So the first thing to do is just that identify your key variables. Which are number one, sliced bread, and number two, agege bread. Now, these are the major variables we have now here. Agege bread, that's what Shola produces. Now, the first thing you are supposed to write now is that we want to develop our model. Now, I've identified this. Why the raw materials? Are what? Flour and butter. These are the two raw materials that Shola makes use of. Now, I'm going to now develop together, we are going to develop the model right now for your understanding.
Now develop our model, LP model for Shola. Now, we have two products. So the first thing you are supposed to do, let's X1 equals sliced bread. Let X2 equals agege bread. So here we are now. Now don't forget, that he makes profit of 12 naira on sliced bread and 16 naira on agege bread. So you now say maximize our profit. So what we want to maximize? The profit of Sholaja. Maximize Z. Z means profit anyway. Profit or anything could be equals to, now maximize the profit. He makes 12 naira profit on a sliced bread. So 12 x1. X1 represents non-unit of sliced bread that Shola that we produce, plus 16 x2. Why x2 represents the unit of agege bread we produce. Are we together? So that's how we are going to do it. Now the total profit is going to get will be depending on the unit of x1 and x2 we produce. Total profit Shola that you're going to get depending on the unit of agege bread and sliced bread he produces. So then to Shola that to him, he would like to maximize to produce 1,000 sliced bread, 1,000 agege bread to maximize profit. But he has a constraint. The resources that he has at hand, they are limited in nature. So those are the constraints. Now say subject to, we are now going to list those constraints out. Number one, it's now telling us that 10 kg of flour is needed to produce a loaf of sliced bread. 10 kg of flour. So it will now be for sliced bread to flour. Flour constraint now. It will now be 10 kg of what? Of flour is needed to produce what? Sliced bread. A sliced bread, so x1 plus, are we together, plus 20 kg of flour is needed for agege bread. 20 kg agege bread x2. Now these are what Sholaja has in his store right now. Like these are the resources he want to use in production. Don't forget, his profit will depend on the unit of x1 and x2 is going to produce. Now, the amount of flour is going to use depending on the unit of x1 and x2 is going to produce. Now, we now have less than equals to 120 kg of flour. Because Sholaja, no matter what he produces, this one, this size must not be greater than this one. It can be equal to this. The implication is that his production level, once he adds x1 and x2 together, multiplied by the unit he uses, they must not be more than 120 kg maximum. Now, when it comes to butter, now, you say 8 kg of butter is needed for sliced bread and 8 kg of butter is also needed for agege bread. So less than equals to total number of what Shola has in store. That's 80 kg of butter. Now, because he wants to minimize resources he's using, this butter, so he wants to minimize these resources. That's why this thing cannot be greater than 120, because this thing must minimize. Mr. Sholaja doesn't have capacity more than 120 flour and 80 kg of butter. So everything he's going to do must be within 120 kg of flour and 80 kg of butter. Now we have got something non-negativity constraint, where we have x1, x2 greater than equal to 0. This implies that it is impossible for Sholaja company to produce products that is less than 0. Is that a company produce or not? So either you produce, if you produce, that's greater than 0. If you don't produce that 0, it can never be negative. So this is our model right now. So we want to introduce simplest method to solve this problem and get the unit of agege bread and sliced bread that Mr. Sholaja must produce. We go on to solve this thing on simplest method. Now, this thing cannot be solved like this because we all did inequalities in high school. So, it will bear with me that this thing cannot be solved like this. We need to convert this side to equality side. So, how are we going to go about that? So, the best thing to do that they write this equation first, maximize it, equals to 12x1 plus 16x2. Subject to now flour now 10 kg x1 plus 20 kg x2. Now, why this equality sign is there is that we are not sure, we are not certain the value this x1 and x2 is going to take. So that's why we need to put less than or equal to. It can either be equal to or it's less than. So now I want to turn into equal sign. What I'm supposed to do is that I'm going to introduce a slack variable, a dummy, that is not doing anything here. So in case x1 and x2 couldn't take that value, my dummy will take it. So I will now say plus x1 equals to 120 kg. Now, immediately I write x1 here, I'll come here and introduce x1, but it should now be 0 because a dummy doesn't have any function. So, 0x1. You will bear with me that what I've written right now is still the same thing to what you have there before, because you just introduce x1 with 0. Anything multiplied by 0 is 0. So, 0 plus what you have there is still the same thing. So, we introduce it there, then you come to butter. You have what? 8 kg x1 plus 8 kg x2 plus x2 here equals to 80 kg. So immediately you introduce this guy, you come here and introduce a dummy here as well, because anything you have here must be here too. So now we want to go and convert this thing to simplest table, then we solve it. So follow me. So the first thing to do is to first write your CJ. CJ means coefficient of those your variables. Coefficient. So here you have basic, under it you can have basic value. Then this one you have CBI. So you rule like this. I will try and minimize my usage so we can have more space to use for other things. So now from here you will translate what you have here to this side. First pick 12 x1. Next one 16 x2. 0x1 0x2, and we have here solution. Then ratio. Now, on this side, we are going to have this place. We are going to have your dummy. We introduce two dummy there, x1 and x2. You have them in x1, x2. So, your CBI will be the coefficient of this dummy. Now be 0, 0. So, we are good to go now. Now, constraint 1, this is where we introduce x1. So, we are going to plug. Take this one, x1, that flower, and put it on x1 here. So, x1, x for x max, on flower is what? 10. So, this x1 here, put it here, 10. x2 on that is what? 20. Then, x1 here is what? 1. while x2 is not there, so we take it at our zero. Y solution is the total units of flour we have in store, that's 120 kg. So we have 120 kg here. So don't let me write kg again. So we come to constraint 2, that's water. We have 8, 8 for x1, 8, x2, 8, x1, for sure that the x1 now is not there, so we take it as 0, and x2 is what? 1. So volume, unit is now what? Solution 80. So I believe we are clear with that. So just underline this like this. Then you are going to find our ZJ. Now, how do we get our ZJ? ZJ is very simple. Just multiply 0 multiplied by 10. 0 multiplied by 10 plus 0 multiplied by 8, yes. So you have 0 plus 0 here. This one will give you 0. You come to x2 here, you do the same thing for x2. 0 multiplied by 20 plus 0 multiplied by 8. 0. Now, on the initial table, everything on this z is going to be 0. So you have 0, 0. Because you multiply this by this plus this by this, you give you 0, 0. Here, 0 as well. So you now have CJ. This is your CJ. Now minus ZJ. So CJ minus ZJ. Let me clean what you have here so you can have more space. CJ, that's CJ minus ZJ. For x1, it will now be 12 minus 0. Give me 12 minus 0, give me 12. 16 minus 0 give me 16. 0 minus 0 give me 0. 0. Now, we are done with the first stage now. Now, this is how we know if we are optimal. We are optimal, optimal level. Condition. Optimal condition is when all our ZJ is less than or equals to 0. When all CJ minus ZJ is less than or equals to 0. That's if you are minimizing. Now, if you are minimizing, it should not be when CJ minus ZJ is greater than or equals to 0. So that's when you are minimizing. But now in this case we are maximizing. So the condition is that CJ minus ZJ must be less than or equal to 0. So this one is greater than 0. Greater than 0. So we are not optimal. That's the implication. We are not optimal. So we want to reiterate the table again. So to the point that we get the optimal value. So the first thing I want to do is just that look at this ZJ, CJ minus ZJ. Which of this number is greater? So I think this is 16. So mark this side. Mark it. 16. This 16 is our what? Is our key column. It's not our key column. Now you come here. Now pick the value on this key column to divide the solution here. So you now have 120 divided by 20 equals. Is right, here 6. Then 80 divided by 8, you have 10. In that place. So you look at this value, which one of them is greater, which one is less, is smaller. So you go for the smaller one. So this is 6. So you now start to this place. Now, this is our key row, this is our key column. In this middle, this place I'm shading, is called key elements. Key elements. Key elements. So, what you have to do right now is to draw another trace table. So, let me try and draw it below it. So, we get my point well. So I'm going to draw this table down here. So I now have CJ table 2. Let me tag in table 2. I now have here CJ DV. You have CVI. Okay. So we now have 12 X1 S2 0 S1 0 S2 solution and ratio. So this is what we have right now here. That same table is what we are going to draw back. So now, here, now, we see here, this is our key row, this is our key column. So we are going to dismiss this value here. Everything here, we don't need them any longer. So we are going to replace this one by this one. So S1 will now take the value of what? S2. And then this one take S2 here. Now, what are the value of S2 here? It's 16. What are the value of S2 here? That's 0. Now, to now get value for this place, we are going to divide every value here by 20. So we now have 10 divided by 20. 20 divided by 20 will give you 1. So 10 divided by 20 will give you 1 over 2. Let me just put that there straight. 1 divided by 20. 0 divided by 20 will give us 0. 120 divided by 20 will give us what? 6. Straight. Now, in this place, we are going to do what? We are going to use old value. Minus correspondence key row. Minus plus multiply by corresponding key column divided by key elements. So bracket this one. So this implies that to get value for this place. Now we are talking for this side. So now get value for this place. This correspond value. Now corresponding key row that the value you want to get, this column here, this cell you want to get, this cell you want to get. What is the corresponding key row? That the value of that, the corresponding value, the value of the corresponding column row of this place. This is the key row. Now, what is the value in this key row that is that corresponds to this place? Is 10 here. So now we, for this side, x is the old value minus corresponding key row of this a is 10 multiply by corresponding key column. This key column for this a is this one too. So everything in this place, this one is corresponding value for a is 10, corresponding key value for this one is this, for this zero on row is this one, these are our row, don't forget this row, for this one is this. Now corresponding key column for 8 is 8. Corresponding key column for this 8 is this 8. Corresponding key column for this 0 is the 8. Do we get? So 8 old value minus into bracket corresponding key row 8, that's return, multiply by corresponding key column, which is 8. Over key element, that's 20. These are key elements. Where is it? It's key element. So we now have what's the value now? 8 minus 80 over 20. So we now have equal to, this will give you 4. 8 over 4. we get 4. So the value for this space will give us 4. Now, for this side, in this space, so still the same method, old value is what? 8. You can see 8. Minus corresponding key row of this is 20. Multiplied by corresponding column is 8. Over 20. So you now have 8 minus this multiplied by this. So we now have 8. This one here, this one here. So we give me what? 0 for this side. Now for S1, old value is what? 0. Old value is 0 minus corresponding key row for this 0 is 1. 1 multiplied by, for this one is 8. Divided by key element is 20. So we now have minus this multiplied by this 8 divided by 20. So we can still break this one down. 4 here will give me what? 2. 4 here will give me what? 5. Minus 2 over 5. For S2, we go the same way. S2, the value of value is just 1 minus corresponding key row of this one is 0, multiplied by corresponding key column is 8, divided by 20. So now I have 1 minus this and this is just 0 over 20. So this is 0 automatically. So now I have 1 as value. Now we go back to this place. To this place. All value is what? 80 minus corresponding key row. That's what? 120 multiplied by corresponding key column. 8 divided by 20. Now we now have 80 minus this multiplied by this will give us 960 divided by 20. Here. So we now have 80 minus 96 over 2. 90 divided by 2 will give us 48. So now I have 80 minus this here 1, this here 48, minus 48. So value now will be 32. 80 minus 48 will give me 32. So the value here is what? 32. Sorry. So now we are done. Let's now rule it and then calculate our ZJ. Our ZJ is still the same method we used the other time that I'm going to use to calculate it this time around. 16 multiplied by 1 over 2 plus 0 multiplied by 4. Now be 16 multiplied by 1 over 2. Plus 0 times 4. So this give me what? Here 1 here 8 plus 0. So we have 8 here. So ZJ for here is what? 8. Now we come here 16 times 1 the bracket plus 0 times 0. 0 multiplied by 0. Give me what? 16. So I have 16 here. Same thing here. 16 multiplied by 1 over 20 plus 0 times minus 2 over 5. This will give me what? 4 here 4, 4 here 5. So I have 4 over 5. This one is going 0 straight. So if I have 4 over 5 here, I have 4 over 5. Then this place we come here. 16 multiplied by 0 plus 0 multiplied by 1. Beginning was 0. So I have 0 here too. So here we have. We are going to do for this place as well. So 16 multiplied by 6 plus 0 multiplied by 30, 16 multiplied by 6. You now give me what? 96. 96 here. So put 96 here. So now CJ minus ZJ. So 12 minus 8 will give us 4. 16 minus 16 give us 0. 0 minus 0 give us minus 4 over 5. 0 minus 2 give us 0. So now you check, our condition is that all the CJ minus ZJ must be less than or equal to 0. So we have 1 here that's not giving us 0 and it's greater than 0. So that's this place. We are going to circle this side and use this place to divide what you have here. So 16 divided by 1 over 2. That's what? 32. 32 divided by 32 divided by 4. 8. So this is the least value here. So we are going to pick it. Then I'll repeat the same process again. So I want to repeat the same process again. Table 3. So we have CJ and BV. CB. It will now be 12 X1 16 S2 0 X1 0 S2. Same thing as the other time. That's what we are putting there back. Solution and ratio. So now, in this place, this side, this one will be leaving. Why this one will be coming in? Because this is the key column. This is the mass number that gave us issue. So these guys must leave. Why this one must enter? So we now have x2 here. Why x1 will take place here? X1 here. So we look at what are the value of x2 here, 16. Value for x1 is 12. Down. So here, before start with this place, this is our key element. This is our key row, this is our key column. So you have to divide every value in this place by 4. So 4 divided by 4 will give you what? 1. 0 divided by 4 will give you what? 0. So you have to look for minus 2 divided by 5 multiplied by divided by 4 to give me minus 1 over 10 x2 1 divided by 4 1 over 4 32 divided by 4 to give me what? 8. Okay, so that's how I'm going to do that. Now in this place we are going to apply the old formula to it, that's old value minus corresponding key row, remember, corresponding key column over key element. So we now have the old value for here is 1 over 2 minus corresponding key row for this place is T4. Corresponding key column for this place too is 1 over 2. Divided by 4. So we now have 1 over 2 minus, this is giving what? 2 over 4. So I now have here 1, here 2. 1 over 2 minus 1 over 2 give us 0. This will be 0. So 0, So we move to x2 here, this place. The old value is brought 1 minus corresponding key row is 0 multiplied by corresponding key column is 1 over 2 divided by what? Divided by 4. So we give you what? 1. You move down to x1 here. Old value is what? 1 over 20 minus bracket corresponding key row is minus 2 over 5 times corresponding key column is what? 1 over 2 divided by key element 4. So it gives me what? 1 over 10. We move to S2. That's the old value. 0 minus corresponding key row is 1 multiplied by 1 over 2 divided by 4. So this gives me what? Minus 1 over 8. Now we get down to solution. Old value on solution is what? 6 minus into brackets. Corresponding key row is what? 32 multiplied by column is 1 over 2 divided by 4. So now let's look for our ZJ. It will now be 16 multiplied by 0, 16 multiplied by 0 plus 12 multiplied by 1. It gives you what? 0 plus 12. This is 12 straight. 12. 16. This place, 16 multiplied by 1 plus 12 multiplied by 0. It gives us 16. Next one, 16 multiplied by 1 over 10 plus 12 multiplied by minus 1 over 10. So this one gives us what? 16 over 10 plus minus 12 over 10. Give me what? Give me minus. Yes. Okay, yeah. Here we have here, we put this on the bracket like this. So here, 2 divided by 16 will give us 8. 2 here will give us 5. Plus times minus give us minus 2 here 6 over 2 here what? 2 here 5. So answer will be what? 2 over 5. So you have 2 over 5 here. Last the next one, 16 multiplied by minus 1 over 8 plus 12 multiplied by 1 over 4. 4 here 1, 4 here 3, 8 here 1, 8 here 2. 2, so we have minus 2 plus 3. We give us what? 1. So this will be 1. So here, 16 multiplied by 2 plus 12 multiplied by 8. So here we have 32 into plus 12 multiplied by 8 will give us 96. So if you sum them, two of them together, what are you going to get? 128. So this is value for this is 128. So let me clean it. I think it should be optimal by this time. Stage. So it now be CJ minus ZJ. 12 minus 12 will give us 0. 16 minus 16 give us 0. 0 minus this one give us minus 2 over 5. 0 minus 1 give us minus 1. So, and the condition is that all CJ, CJ minus ZJ must be less than or equal to 0. So we are optimal at this stage. Now, the value you get here is the value of for our maximize z equals to 12x plus 16x2. Now, the interpretation of this thing is that we are telling the company that they should produce 2 of x2 and 8 of x1. So the company should produce over here. That's the interpretation. If you finish this thing without interpreting it, it's wrong. So we now tell them that x1 equals to, what is x1 here? 8. X2 is equal to 2. So solar jar should produce 8 of slice bread and 2 agave bread. So once they produce that, what will be the solar jar's profit? You are now going to plug this value into, let me write, max z equals to 12 into bracket, what is x1? 8 plus what is x2? 16 into bracket 2. So this evaluation will give you what? 128 naira. So that's it. You are now advising solar jar to produce 12 units of sliced bread and 2 agave bread to maximize profit of 128 naira. That's what you are going to get. So thank you. We try and look for 3 variables at a time that involves 3 products. Some other time permits. Thank you and God bless you.